Hello!
Welcome to SA Nights. The SA Slayers. My name is Julie and I will be your instructor as we read through formative and summative assessment essay. The article source is embedded in the video description below. Feel free to read along. Please note that you can get a custom, plagiarism-free essay for as little as $10 a page at SA Nights. The link is in the description. 1.2 Summarize the difference between formative and summative assessment. Formative assessment is typically contrasted with a summative assessment. The former supports teachers and students in decision-making during educational and learning processes, while the latter occurs at the end of a learning unit and determines if the content being taught was retained. P. Ainsworth, 2006, Wikipedia, 1.1 Compare and contrast the roles of the teacher and the TA in assessment of learners on registered trademark achievements. 1.5 Explain how assessment for learning can contribute to planning for future learning carried out by A, the teacher B, the learner C, the learning support practitioner. Teachers are responsible for following the national curriculum, planning lessons, providing the necessary resources for the children. A teacher unregistered trademark's responsibility towards the children in their care can involve the following. Deliver an ongoing record of each child unregistered trademark's progress. Inform children about their personal progress and achievements. Keep parents up to date and informed regarding strengths and areas for improvement for their child. Identify educational needs for all of the children within the class. A teaching assistant works alongside and in partnership with the teacher. They are there to support the teacher, help and assist children in their education. A teaching assistant can relay back to the teacher whether they think a child may need help in developing in certain areas, and a plan can be put in place in which may require the assistance of the teaching assistant. However, the teacher is the overall boss unregistered trademark of the class and will advise the teaching assistant what is required for that day. Children are assessed on a daily basis. This enables the teacher to reflect whether a lesson is working to meet the learning objectives or whether how we achieve the objective needs to be changed. The school I am currently working in has taken the assessment a step further. They are following OE, the Shanghai Maths Unregistered Trademark System. The children are not set in a particular group for maths ability but are assessed while doing the task. The children are taught a short maths lesson on the carpet, and then asked to go to a table and fill out a maths prepared paper. The teacher will then go around and mark the work and asking the child to go back to the carpet once it has been marked. Once the children are back at the carpet, they are then told what will be the next step of the lesson. At this point, this is where they are put into groups based on ability of this particular lesson. By doing this new system, it enabled to the teacher to assess every part of the child unregistered trademark's ability in maths and what the teachers and teaching assistants can help develop. A teacher will then adapt lessons to suit individual requirements for children and discuss with the teaching assistant how they achieve the learning objective. If the need is greater and is more specialized, a learning support practitioner will give the teacher and children the support needed to achieve the goal at hand. 1.3 Explain the characteristics of assessment for learning. 1.4 Explain the importance and benefits of assessment for learning. Assessment for learning is an essential part of a child unregistered trademark's education. It can define if the fundamental educational needs are being met. Assessments affect decisions about grades, educational needs and in some cases schools' funding. The assessing will also establish a child unregistered trademark's academic progression. A number of assessment for learning strategies can be used to help children. Teachers can gain a further understanding of the strategies needed to aid learning. Typical characteristics of assessment for learning are: enable teachers to plan stages of a child unregistered trademark's development to ensure individual progress, provide a consistent whole school approach that encourages teaching and learning, involve pupils within all of the lessons, help pupils understand the learning objective in question or how we can make better next time. Active listening from pupil and teacher to enable the learning, encouraging enthusiasm and self-esteem can help a child develop their own assessment for learning, encourage children to think and question, and do this on their own and in groups will help the child evaluate themselves. Once a child has started to develop the understanding of being able to evaluate themselves, they will understand their own strengths. If the child is able to discuss their own evaluation with a teacher, they may gain a deeper understanding of their learning, which may give the child confidence and motivate them. As part of the assessment for learning, all teachers should emphasize to all children that it is good to have a go. And even if the answer is wrong, we can learn from this. Thank you for taking your time to listen to me. I hope you enjoyed learning about formative and summative assessment essay as much as I did. Kindly remember that you can get a custom, plagiarism-free essay at Essay Nights for as little as $10. The link is in the description. See you next time.